guys, I'm really excited to bring this series to you. Every time I do an episode called The McBride Collection, I'm going to dive into my friend's collection that he gave me. If you've heard me refer to him or refer to someone as my music mentor all this last year and a half, almost 2 years in the VC, that's who I'm talking about. He's a very good friend of mine. I learned so much from him. He's also a drummer. Does a lot of, plays in local bands and has played in local bands through the years, and has a deep passion for music, but no longer has a passion for vinyl. About 5 years ago, he came to me and said, "Hey, I have a vinyl record collection." Over the years, I'd visited his place a few times, and every now and then he'd float me a record. We'd be talking about Deep Purple, and he'd say, "You can go ahead and take that home." So he held on to a bulk of his collection for five more years. But tragically, his son died at a very young age. And through no fault of his own, he had a health condition, spiraled out of control very quickly, and just passed away, and just was a shock to him and the family and everybody that knew McBride. So that being said, I think sometime later, he realized that nobody was going to get his record collection, or he didn't have anyone to give his record collection to. So at that point, I think maybe he's starting to grieve and to let things go, and he knew I had a passion for vinyl, and I was the first person he thought of, and he thought, maybe someone should have the collection. It should be Corey. So I, with a lot of respect to McBride and his son, I accepted the collection, and I want to treat it right and take care of it. So none of these records are for sale. Sometime down the line, I may consider a trade. I'm not sure. Maybe like with one of the vinyl community members, we want to do a trade on some things, that something in here really interests you. As long as I know it's going to a good home and it's going to be loved, I think that's okay. There's a little over 170 albums consisting of classic rock, prog rock, jazz, art rock, and a few other surprises in there. So what I want to do is dive into the record collection. And what I'm doing is going through the album, looking at it, kind of grading it, adding it to my Discogs collection. And then also listening to the record and pulling up information on the band and learning as I go. One thing that's really awesome about the McBride collection, everything is near mint. I've never seen this many albums in such a consistent condition, in such excellent condition. One thing about it that McBride explained to me was that he didn't have record sleeves back when he was buying records and coming up into Columbus to the record store we had then. And what he would do is he would actually tape the cellophane back to the album when he collected them. So he took very good care of this collection from the very beginning. However, now that the cellophane has been taken off, it did leave some tape around the sides. So what you have is a record like this one here, this Straub's record, has no ring wear whatsoever. So it's just immaculate. But you do have this tape, and then sometimes you might have a little tape residue. Some albums you may not see any at all, or sometimes you see just a little bit on the inside where he's taped the cellophane to the record. So it's pretty much, what would you rather have? No tape at all in the ring wear, or no ring wear in the tape? And it doesn't bother me at all. But other than that, they're mine to take care of, catalog, and love. So McBride, I just want to say thank you very much for the collection. I'm going to take care of it and love it like you know I would. That's why you picked me. And just want to say thank you very much. And also just thanks for being a mentor and hanging out, and most of all, being a really good friend.